Hi guys, welcome back to YouTube channel Foundation Chemistry AB. So today we will talk about Introduction to Fundamentals of Chemistry lab class. So this video will be highly beneficial for 10th, 11th and 12th students. So I have a simple message for you. Please think for innovation, be creative and learn smartly everywhere, anytime and help to learn others. So today we'll talk about the safety measures need to be taken inside the chemistry lab. And suppose some accident will occur. So what are the things you need to do as first aid? And today we'll recognize different glassware and instruments generally used in the lab. And we'll talk about normality, molarity and molality concept. And how to prepare one normal, one molar and one molal solution. And different types of titrations and basic equations used for calculation in chemistry, and what are the experiments students generally carry out inside the lab. So this is a simple or nice view of chemistry lab. So here you can find water taps, basins, gas burners or Bunsen burner, reacts, chemicals, fire extinguisher, blackboard, working table, etc. So suppose you enter to the chemistry lab, so you should take care of the safety first. So you must maintain discipline during laboratory class. The student must wear apron, safety glass, hand gloves and full shoes while working in the laboratory. They must clean glassware properly before and after use and should check that glassware have no cracks. And never perform any unauthorized experiments on your own and never test or inhale any compound because they are toxic. So keep the mouth of the test tube away from yourself and others while heating in a burner. You must read the labels carefully before taking any chemical from the container. Student must be very careful while handling chemicals such as acids, benzene, phenols, etc. And fume hoods must be used while handling chemicals and carrying out different reactions. And please put the waste such as paper, solvents, broken glasses, reaction byproducts into the respective labeled containers or dustbins. And please use minimum quantity of the reagent or chemicals because all the chemicals nowadays very costly. So after using a chemical, the container must be tightly closed and returned to its original place. You are advised to clear all your conceptual doubts and practical understanding and applications of the experiment before doing the experiment. And you must follow the experimental procedure strictly while taking chemicals, handling different apparatus, glassware, instruments. And you must handle glassware very carefully as they are very fragile. Students are advised to report immediately to the concerned teacher if any accident or hazard occurs inside the laboratory. And you must switch off all electrical instruments and turn off the gas burners and water taps after your work is over. So suppose some accident will occur. So what you need to do as first aid? So suppose there is a cut due to the glassware. So you need to wash the wound well with cold water immediately. If the bleeding is severe, then apply pressure directly onto the wound. To stop bleeding, then apply antiseptic cream. Suppose you have a body burn caused due to acid spilling. So wash it with water, then with sodium bicarbonate solution, then apply Vaseline. So suppose there is a body burn caused due to alkali spilling. So wash with water, then with boric acid solution. Then please apply the paste of boric acid for 10 to 15 minutes and wash it again. Suppose you have a body burn caused due to bromine spilling. So wash it with water, then with 2 molar ammonia solution, then keep the affected part of dipped in sodium bisulfite solution till bromine is washed off, then apply Vaseline. Suppose there is a body burn due to the phenol spilling. So wash it with ethanol first, then you go for hospital treatment. So suppose there is a spillage of acid inside the eye. So wash it with plenty of water, then wash it with 2% sodium bicarbonate solution, then put 2 to 3 drops of olive oil. Spillage of alkali in eye, wash with plenty of water, then dilute boric acid 5% and and again clean with water, and then put 2 to 3 drops of olive oil. And so suppose there is a chemical poisoning. So suppose someone swallow poisonous chemical, so plenty of water should be given. And for corrosive poison, calcium hydroxide solution should be given. So these are the minimum things a chemistry student must use inside the chemistry lab. First thing is apron, then safety glass for safety of eye, then full suits, gloves, matchbox, lab rough notebook, and lab record. So here you can see the boy is working and doing some experiment, and you can see he wears a apron. So in chemistry lab, apron is must. So this girl is wearing a safety glass and wearing gloves. And inside chemistry lab, no slippers or no sandals, because suppose some there acid spilling on your leg, so it will damage your skin. So always please wear full suits while coming to chemistry laboratory. So what are the glassware used frequently inside the chemistry lab? This one, conical flasks, they are of different sizes. Similarly, this one is called beaker. They are also of different sizes. This one is volumetric flask. So here you can see a mark. So the lower meniscus of the liquid should touch this line. And this tubular one, that is known as measuring cylinder, they are of different sizes. You can see this one is 100 ml measuring cylinder. This one is known as reagent bottle, where you store different chemicals. So just above this conical flask, you see this is called glass funnel. And this one is filter paper. So using filter paper and funnel, you can filter different reaction products. So this one, test tube, which is stored in a test tube stand, and this rod type dipped in the conical flask, it is known as glass rod. This is used to mixing or stirring purpose. And this is the picture of Bunsen burner. So it has three parts, metal base, and here you have a regulator called collar and burner tube. So when you put the gas on and light with a lighter or matchbox, you get this flame, this kind of flame. You can see it has a inner zone and outer zone. So this blue zone, blue colored zone, is known as luminous flame. And here you find most of the carbon monoxide. And this one is known as flame blower. So this flame blower is used to blow this flame into the charcoal cavity where the salt or compound was taken. And this one is double blue glass. So this is used during flame test to see the different colors. This one is known as wash bottle. This is used to wash different types of glassware and make up the volume. And this one, graduated bottle, you can see up to this mark it is 800 ml. This one is a test tube holder. So you can put the test tube here and tight it. And you can use for different purpose, also for heating test tube. This one is a crucible tong. This is used to hold different hot items like crucibles. This one is known as watch glass. This instrument is known as burette. How it look like? So it has maximum capacity 50 ml. So 0 to 50 ml it is marked. And you need to know how to use this burette. So this burette is fixed in a stand, that is known as burette stand, and this one is called volumetric pipette. So they are of different sizes, 25 ml, 10 ml, like that. And these are called graduated pipette. They are of also different sizes. You can see 3 ml, 5 ml, 10 ml, and these are called pipette bulb. These pipette bulbs are used to suck different solutions. This is known as a digital weighing machine. So where you can take the exact weight of different chemicals. And this one is called round bottom flask. It is used to carry out different reactions. And during preparation or synthesis, mostly you will use fume hood. So here you can see the different regulators for air, oxygen, nitrogen, like that. And this is a small lab, where you can carry out all your reactions safely. And this one, magnetic stirrer with heating system. and this one is called condenser. So all these things you need while doing preparation or synthesis. And this one is known as tripod stand, and above it wire gauge. This is porcelain basin, and this is water oil bath. So nowadays a digital oil or water bath also available. So now we'll talk about what is normality. So how to prepare one normal solution. So what is normality? Normality is number of gram equivalents of solute per 1000 ml of solution. So suppose we are interested in preparing oxalic acid one normal solution. So what will be its molecular weight? Is 126 gram per mole. So if you look at the reaction here, two number of electrons are released. So my equivalent weight is molecular weight divided by the number of electrons in business. So that is 63 grams. So that means we can get one normal solution of oxalic acid by dissolving 63 gram of oxalic acid, that is its equivalent weight, in 1 liter of water. So the unit of normality is gram per liter. Next thing is how to prepare one molar solution. So what is molarity? So it is denoted by capital M. So the number of moles of solute per 1000 ml of solution. So suppose we are interested in preparing 1 molar solution of sodium hydroxide. So molecular weight is 40 gram per mole. So 1 mole of sodium hydroxide equal to 40 grams. So that means we can get 1 molar solution of sodium hydroxide by dissolving 40 gram of sodium hydroxide in 1 liter of water. So unit of molarity is mole per liter. So next, how we can prepare one molar solution. So what is molality? That is denoted by small m. So molality is number of moles of solute per kg of solvent, or mass of solvent in kg. So suppose we are interested in preparing one molar solution of sodium hydroxide. So molecular weight is 40 gram per mole. So 1 mole of sodium hydroxide equal to 40 grams. So that means we can get 1 molar solution of sodium hydroxide by dissolving 40 gram of sodium hydroxide in 1 kg or 1000 grams of water or any solvent. So the unit of molality is mole per kg. So now we'll discuss what are the experiments that student will carry out inside the chemistry lab. So mostly the students will carry out single or double titration. So what is single titration? When one acid is titrated against the one base, then that is called single titration. And in double titration, what will happen? One acid will be titrated against two bases, or one base will be titrated against two acids. So in that case, there you have to do two titrations. So that is called double titration. And student will prepare some inorganic compounds like more salt, potassium, and they will carry out salt analysis like acid radicals, basic radicals, and student will identify organic functional group or substances, and student will learn different types of instruments and glassware in detail inside the chemistry lab. So when we talk about titration, there are different types: acid base titration, redox titration, iodometric titration. When acid HCl is titrated with the base, that is called acid base titration. And this is the basic equation used while in calculation. So 1000 ml of one normal solution HCl equal to 1000 ml of one normal sodium hydroxide, that is equal to its equivalent weight, that is 40 grams of sodium hydroxide. Similarly, in redox titration, so suppose iron is titrated against standard potassium dichromate solution. So your basic equation used will be 1000 ml of one normal potassium dichromate equal to 1000 ml of one normal iron solution. That is equal to 1 gram equivalent of iron, that is equal to 55.85 gram of iron. So that means in redox titration, one will be oxidized and other one will be reduced. Similarly, in iodometric titration, the liberated iodine will be titrated against standard sodium thiosulfate solution. So in summary, we have discussed the safety measures need to be taken inside chemistry lab and what are the things the student must do as first aid, and we recognized different glassware and instruments and things, and we discussed the concept normality, molarity and molality, how to prepare one normal, one molar and one molar solution, and different types of titrations and basic equations used for calculation. So we will be happy if you guys subscribe to our channel Foundation Chemistry AV. So this is also available in the website www.foundationchemistryab.com. So this is a simple step towards e-learning, making life better. So thank you all for learning.